This conference
अगर
will now
मन
be
खोले,
recorded.
हेलो
यस सर, टेल मी.
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इट्स एसएपी वेलकम वेलकम टू द एसएपी वर्ल्ड एंड वी हैव अ ईआरपी. इट्स ईआरपी मींस एंटरप्राइज रिसोर्स प्लानिंग. मींस एंटरप्राइज वेरियस ट्रांजैक्शन टेक प्लेस लाइक बिजनेस at any company, it will call comes under the enterprise, and the customers get the satisfaction, and where the resources are available for the people's needs, like not only products, service also comes under the enterprise place only. And another one is the resource. Resources means what kind of resources we require for the entering the one company, or we have to organize one business or some anything. So it's required mainly money, and man, and machines and materials. These are the four main key roles for the any business or any company they require for the run the profit wise. Money is the everyone who know we require the investment. Man means manpower we require. Machines means machinery, like manufacturing machineries we require. And material, it comes under the raw material or semi finished goods comes under this material. These four are we require for the resource to run the business. And planning. Planning means proper planning and optimize of the valuable resource make enterprise run into profits. So every company main aim is they want to get the profits or any business. So they require the proper planning to get the profits. That comes under the planning section. Like we have a definition for the ERP RISE. It's a book definition, but we need not require to remember all these things. A software solution that addresses the enterprise's needs, taking the process view of an organization to meet the organization goals. Tightly integrate all functions of enterprise. This is the one book definition, don't worry. So simply we can say that for enterprise resource planning, who will plan the proper resources and getting the profits come profits from the business that will come under the ERP. In ERP we have a lot of softwares, like I will tell you. These are the products for the ERP, like SAP is the one of the main product from the ERP, and BAN, Oracle apps also comes under the ERP, PeopleSoft, JD Edwards, Mercer, and a lot of extras also. But all softwares, apart from all software, SAP is the one of the major part of the ERP. Every business people are installing SAP because it's providing the all needs in one place. That's the reason SAP is the top one in the ERP products, because material management, financial, and HR, all models comes under this SAP one. In case of Oracle, we are going for the Oracle apps. We have a database one we are using. They require the manufacturing all these things. They have to go for the another software, PeopleSoft and Java, .NET, and all these things. But in SAP, we are getting the all needs in one place. That is the reason SAP is the number one in the ERP.
What are the competitions for our SAP, sir?
Yeah, Oracle apps. Major Oracle.
Okay, and Salesforce?
Salesforce is comes under the SAP, but it's a tool, we can say that one, because it's one of the tools. So business wise, they're using Salesforce, but it's not that much of compared to SAP.
Okay.
SD like.
Okay. So many people in automobile industry, people are using Salesforce.
Salesforce, it's one of the tool actually. After SAP only, they're creating the one tool. And for the shortcuts, like we can say that shortcuts for this business. Okay. But previously it was almost 5 years back, it was very good boom, Salesforce. But it's not that much of hype created. Present this, it's okay, but not compared to the SD and S4HANA.
Okay, so this SD comes under S4HANA. What is the meaning, sir? I heard so many times this S4HANA. C4HANA, I know it's a combination of five.
I will tell you. Actually, we have a next today's section, tomorrow section. I will give you the what is the glance S4 SAP R by R3 R structure. Entirely, I will tell you. While R3, okay. We have a R3 and R4 and S4 now, like CRM, Salesforce. Mm-hmm. We have some extra features like patches and all these things. So I will let you know what is the S4HANA exactly, and present what are your SAP SD, what is the difference between the SAP SD and the SAP S4HANA.
Yes.
Morning, Shiva. Sandeep here.
Yeah, good morning, Sandeep.
Yeah, so we are talking about the ERP products, right? So so looking at the development on AI and machine learning, how those going to affect, is there any effect would be on the SAP, or would there be any chances that any other product might beat this? And like how can we be confident on the SAP product?
It's a good question. Actually, in ERP we have a lot of products, but it comes under the SAP. Mm-hmm. It's giving all needs in one roof. For example, okay. While we are organization one, we are maintaining one organization, we require a lot of modules. Am I right?
Right.
So in that SAP, what happened? It's already ready-made software we have, and business need depend upon business need. We have to understand the what the requirement and what is available in SAP. We have to map it actually. If there is not possible in this SAP already, if it's not available in the SAP, we can customize that one. So that is the beauty of the SAP. Remaining softwares and all these things, PeopleSoft and Oracle apps, already they have. And also, we could maintain the everything coding and mean, like the Oracle PeopleSoft we are using, they require some backup like to. And all this, but in SAP we have a ticket also like above, and basis also data is related entirely and operation and all this. So once we install the SAP, so it will give the all needs. So need not to go for the any other software. That is the reason it's almost 70% caps the market entirely, apart from all other products.
Okay.
And also, project we have some version actually. So in case of there is any future requirements, like previously we don't have any Facebook, Twitter and the online business and all this thing. If new business has come, so we can add the patch like PH1, PH2, PH3, we can add it. Same software only, same our SAP only. So need not to install new software and we have to migrate the data entirely, it's not required. So already we have some software, there is any new version, so we can directly migrate that new version. So that's the reason every company required every company want to SAP one.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you. Mm. Yeah. Great.
Just I'm giving the glance. It's because of what is happening in the market. It's not exactly our SAP SD subject, but what is SAP and how it's working, ERP, what is the use of SAP, like we are checking only. And what is the need of ERP? Integration business process. Yes, online information at the corporate office and standardized system across locations, because we can use this cover system in every country, not only one country. So every country we can use the same system for the SAP. Reduce cash to cash cycle times, because in case of we are going for the any other software, we have to go for another department to take the in order, or maybe we have to wait for the database, because every night database are moving from the one system to one system, depend upon the jobs and all this thing. But in the SAP, we can directly see the jobs and all this thing. Faster consumption of head office for statutory reporting, like reporting purpose also, we have a dashboards, we can call the dashboards. I will let you know directly what is the dashboards and reports and everything. Don't worry. And coming into the problem tackled by ERP system, material shortages, product enhancement, customer services, cash management, inventory problems, quality problems. These are the different problems faced in the previously, but now they maintain the all these things, because material shortage is the material management. We have some different version like warehouse management and all these things included in this place, and product enhancements and customer service like CS. I think you are heard or not. Like SAP, we have a HR, MM, like we have also CSC also. They introduced last 10 years back only. CSC, customer service support also, they introduced cash management, inventory problems, and quality problems also. These all are the just PPT only, don't worry. I'm not going the subject. Just SAP and competitors, what is the competitors available in the market? Like R3 had competitors of your games, you know, like I what I also do, Oracle, it's a main important. It's a competitor of the our SAP. Oracle with its EB suite tagged to Excel with 442 modules. And PeopleSoft with extra log, all these things, it's not required. Just for your reference one. So SAP consultant companies, these are the companies. So not only these companies, every company is present, they are implementing the SAP to the our clients, like Accenture, Capgemini, Intel Group, IBM, every company are now working with SAP to sell the SAP to the our clients, like customers like Tata's Data Red Labs, Rambas, L&T, Reliance Industry, BMW, Nano, all automobiles, banking sectors. Every company is now using SAP because a company want to go for the highest level software. For example, in case of Tata is using SAP software, then what happened? BMW, oh, Tata company is using SAP, so we have to go for the SAP only because we do not require for the Oracle, Java. It's old systems. SAP is the fastest and simply cash and sales and reporting purpose. So that's the reason every company is using SAP, but it's very costly compared to other products. Even though some standards they're using, big companies, every company, they want to go for the good standard. That's the reason they want to install the SAP. And coming to the SAP compared to the other softwares like .NET, Java, testing, Oracle and all these things, it's a high package. For example, normal 2 to 3 years experience people have a 4 to 5 lakhs in other modules. But coming to the SAP, we will get 7 to 10 lakhs between, depend upon your background, means your qualification and your domain experience, your skills also. So there is a difference between the other softwares and SAP. Trina, it's okay. Are you? I'm going very fast. Or it's okay.
No problem, sir. This is all completely theoretical subject. Ah, we can understand easily.
For the while introduction of SAP and all this.
Yeah.
SAP R3, what is all about SAP? System application, product and data processing. This is the definition of system application and products and data processing. A lot of people call SAP, but it's a single words like S means systems applications and systems applications and the products and data processing. This is the different we can call SAP. And coming to the SAP model, SAP package is strategically divided into two main areas, like functional and technical. What is the functional and technical? People with domain experience can work on a functional models. Second, two technical models are above four biases. Cross references are used for ALE purpose. I will tell you. In SAP, we call functional consultants, technical consultant. Functional, what is a functional consultant? Means who understands the business needs and depend upon the business need, who provide the software to the client. That comes under functional, but we don't require any coding knowledge and .NET, Java, C, C++, and all these things. Just for business understanding, we require. In functional consulting, we require the domain experience. Because we need to understand the what is the requirement. For example, we are coming to the salespeople. We have to know the what is the sales happen, what is the inquiry, what is the quotation, how it will be go for the delivery, what is the bill or invoice payment. So we have to understand the what is the domain exactly. Then we can map to the SAP. So they require the domain experience. That comes from the functional people. Like in functional, we have a SD, sales and distribution. Material management means we require the material. So that comes from the material management. PP, production planning. Once material management is available, we require the production. Because for example, this year 2020-21, they require the 1,000 cars. So depend upon the requirement, they will plan the production also. So to 1,000 cost the requirements, they require the metal also, that raw material like steel and tires and all this comes under the metal management. And once material prepared, production completed, then we require the finance department. Not only before, also we require after completion, not only after completion. Because finance department will completely finance related information. This is the profit and loss and tally and all comes under the finance. Nowadays it comes under CEO also, finance control, FICO they call. FICO, simply called financial and controlling. And tell it comes under the SD functional side of apart from HR, human resource. Because we are getting the salaries, we are a lot of people recruiting and they are providing salaries and attendance, timing and shift allowances all comes under the HR. These are like we have a lot of modules comes under the functional side. Coming to the technical, who is the technical? Means above, we are calling above. Above means they are writing the some codes depend upon the client requirement. But we have to interact with the client from functional side only. Technical people, we have to take the input from the client and we have to understand what is the requirement. If there is not available in SAP, we have to give the above people. So we require this kind of feature. Like we have to explain the what exactly requirement from the client side. Then above people will write the coding. So once coding is completed, we have to test it. Depend upon the requirement, it's matching or there is any problem, any errors or maybe any deviation from the our requirement. So once coding is completed, we have to test it. Then it's okay. Then we can go for the production system. I will let you know what is the production development system now. This is the process. Technical means above comes under. Apart from above, we have a basis also. Basis means it's nothing but authorization. Who can use the particular system? So for example, production system, we don't have a authorization for everyone. In case of I'm an SD functional, I cannot get the authorization for the FICO, I cannot get the HR, PP, and all this. Am I right? So, depend upon their role, they are providing the authorizations and also jobs and business like database related information they are maintaining. Basis report. Main important is the authorization.
So, in a simple words, we can say it as an administrator. Administrator.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. So in case of we require any system access or we can go for the any related information, they will provide you. We have to provide the some approvals, then only they can give the authorization admin. So these are the SAP functional and technical. But coming to the different software, they call the software engineer and all this thing. But coming to the SAP, they will call the consultant, functional consultant and technical consultant, we call it. Divided into functional technical consultants. Yeah, SAP, technical functional. This is the another third one is the techno functional, they were called. Techno function means nothing but who have experience in technical wise and functional wise. That is still called technical functional. Because, for example, I'm past 10 years onwards this SAP SD. So I have got some knowledge on the technical also, because debugging, we call the debugging. If there is an issue coming to the like order or delivery time, we can go for the coding level and we have to check why it's the order is not delivering to certain time. In case of functional, we cannot find out, we can go for the coding level. So we can check for the code. Okay, what is the order type or what is the sales date? So and so date last month, for example, eighth date. But we cannot find the any solution, any error from in functional side. So we can go for the directly coding level. What kind of code they written? So that's called debug. We can call that debug. Debugging. So who have a knowledge in the debugging and some technical knowledge, that comes under the techno function people. Techno function. It's a rare people. But in case of we have a knowledge in the techno function, that's very advantage to the project and company also. But don't worry, first we have to consider the functional learning. Once we have a functionally strong, then we can understand the technical. In functional area, we have around 64 modules. all are unbilled for web reporting via web application service. Nowadays, everything comes under the web application only. Because all are put on social media, they are working. So that's the reason every order or delivery, anything, it goes comes under the social media like Twitter, like Facebook and WhatsApp. Even messages also, it's now enabled.
Web application means it's a cloud you are talking.
Yes, yes. I will tell you what is the S4 while explaining S4ANA. I will let you know how the data is coming and data is quick like cloud and all this. The SAP companies are it's a old data, like a lot of countries are working and all this thing. Lot of partners, what is the generation of the SAP and all this thing. It's not required for our best, just for this PPT they provided.
This is latest like, information or old information?
It's old it also.
Okay.
But R1, R2, R3, SAP, one step, my SAP, now S4 and actually. SAP milestone over 30 years, like it's increasing, millions wise and all this things.
Okay.
Yeah. Here first started actually one type structure and second two type and three type. What is one type and two type and three type? It's a single tier architecture, standard system like PCs. Previously you can know that when we have some system means they have some PC, monitor, CPU, remember before laptop and all this thing. Like we have a different places in one system actually. Database layer, application layer, presenters layer. We have three systems actually. Database, Oracle they are using, core comp process, actually application process, and GU frontend they are using. But nowadays it comes under the only one system, but previously they used the different systems. That comes under the single type system. Database layer, application layer, presenters layer. I mean presenters layer, frontend actually. What we see that, for example, while we are going for the Amazon, all these things. Just we can go for the Amazon.in. Then we can see the front end that comes under the GUI. Okay. Application layer means who have a consultants work for the application layer. What kind of screen we have to see that one? It's a friendly screen. We have to show that one. In case of we are going for the desktop, it's a different and phone like smartphones, they have some different screens. So how their applications are visible. That comes under the application layer and database layer means where the database stored. It's in under servers, they are maintaining a lot of servers. So that comes in the database layer. So previously they are using the database Oracle and CoreCom, GA frontend like these kind. After two type, what happened? Database application layers are different. Same, one server, but pieces are different pieces. Like what we can say, internet centers. What happened, lot of systems they put it, but they put it the database and application layer is one place. Different pieces they can use. After generation, they started the three type. This is the three type. SAP R3 works on three type architecture, user terminal. So in company, they are using user terminal, application service in different, like one main branch, they maintain the entire database and second branches are, they are giving the inputs and send to the report to the main branch only, like application server, database server. Data creation, modification, retrievers, entirely head office they are maintaining, managing user request, data storage, and all this comes under the database server. But nowadays they are using a lot of S4ANA cloud and all these things. So lot of what we can say about users you can use at a time. In case of I think best example IRCTC, anytime we can wait for like tatkal time, 10 o'clock or something. So that server is busy because of they don't use the proper network and proper software. They're using government like normally. In case of SAP, we can go for the Amazon or Flipkart and all this. While the sales time, they are giving the within 1 hour or something time. But even though a lot of at that time, 1 lakh people or 2 lakh people also using same application, there is no hang and all this thing. The SAP world, like what I said, like modules, SD is the sales and distribution, MM is the material management, PP is production planning, and quality management QA. Quality also checking for the once product is completed. Plant maintenance, and HR human resource, ICE industry solutions, workflows and project systems, AM, fixed assets management, like a lot of modules we have. Treat their clients, the presentation layer, like presentation layer, front end, like what we can see this in the mobile or desktop, and application layer, and then program, like consultants, what we consultants, we done the application. For example, while we're kicking this product, it will go for the select the particular pin code, it's available or not. It's available, then keep your username, depend upon your username. Okay, this product is purchased by so-and-so name. So we have to integrate all this data and all this. Once it's application layer complete, database layer, it will go to the entire storage. Okay, so-and-so registered user, they purchased the so-and-so product with so-and-so rate. So they maintain the data, the database layer. These are the three layers. Industry wise, a lot of industries, the 10% five, like chemical companies, retail companies, manufacturing companies, or banking sectors. What is the business shares of this SAP? Like industry wise, banks, customer availability, exchange management, oil and gas, route probability, automotive, media, and tell every, not only one industry, every industry now using the SAP only. 99%, 90%. 10% remaining 10% Oracle they are using maximum. So what kind of companies are using high tech, media, oil and gas, health tech and all this thing? I'm not going for this thing. Common SAP main important is the common SAP objectivity. Cost control, this is the main important. Why we are going for the SAP means cost control, increased profitability and increased productivity of all resources, man, material, money and machinery. Process standardization, this is the main important. Process standardization, once we implemented the SAP, so need not to worry for the next after 10 years or something new version or new version or new business process. So we can map it only. So need not to go for the entire new version, new system. Just we can patch the already existing system to new system. Then it will go work for the future requirement also. Transparency operation resulting better communication. Yes, transparency operation is. For example, anytime we can go for this order place, we can check, okay, what is the my order status? When will you delivery? Like we can route map also, we can search for the what is the next level, next steps and all these things. So it's entirely transparency. And shift from post-mortem scenarios to predictive scenarios. Like previously, we have a lot of scenarios. We have to manual interaction, a lot of manual interaction. But nowadays, it's entirely automatically. We cannot wait for the manual confirmation and all these things. These are the, I think you can feel bored, but it's just a formality and say results of integration, focus on business process, elimination of redundant data, easier corporate and better management and all these things. It's not required. Success facts for SAP implementation, top management committees, all this training. I'm skipping all these things because it's just for information only. This is the SAP implementation pages. Project planning, business process, installation, training, business requirement mapping, configuration, modification, data conversation, documentation, testing, goal and post-production support. Actually, while implementing one product to the one company, so we have to maintain the, all these pages. But we all pages just comes under the ASAP methodology we call. Like still we have some fish model and waterfall model, like what is the process you are using in your company to install the SAP, they all call it, or they ask you. So this simply ASAP method, A means accelerated SAP methodology we are using. Means first one is, first stage is the project preparation. What is project preparation? Means depend upon the client requirement, we have to know that what exactly what kind of they need. For example, it's automotive mobile, automotives industry. They say, sir, we have a lot of branches in the India, not only India, out of country also. We required 1 lakh customer and we have a lot of model, more different kinds of cars also. So we require some SAP, they will tell you. So we have to understand, okay, They require the regional wise, and they have a lot of branches, and they have a lot of models of costs also, and they have a 1 lakh customers, and we have to integrate all these things. This comes under the project preparation, and we can give the quotation. Okay, this project will comes under the 1 year. We require the this much of 100 crores for this project, and this kind of resources we require. We have to give the entire what we require for that particular project. This is the project preparation first step. And second one is the business blueprint. Business blueprint, they will give the roadmap. Like, okay, first 3 months we are using the functional customers build the functional side requirements and the gathering and functional specification. Second 3 months, they technical people are providing the entire coding. And third quarter, they will testing it's working that properly or not. Fourth quarter, we will implement the our project to the client place. Like, we have a business blueprint. I will tell you simple layman language. For example, in case of we are purchasing or we are building any house and all these things, first step, what we have to know, what is our budget, what is the time frame, where is the place, am I right? Then once our budget, for example, my budget is 1 C, and I require 3-bedroom flat or something, so I have to plan that. Okay, within 1 year I have to 3-bedroom flat. So where is location? And what kind of amenities we require, like it's a gated or something, all comes under the first project preparation. Like our project also prepared. Okay, we require 3-bedroom house, 1 C, and what is the time frame, 1 year, and all this. Once it's completed, second is blueprint. Blueprint means nothing but they are going for the engineer and they will give you the structure. Okay, this is the 3-bedroom and this is the kitchen, this is the all this thing, and you require the balcony and all this. Like blueprint also in our SAP, we will give the okay functional consult people 5 members, technical people 5 members, they are creating MM required, HR required, PP required, and this is the roadmap, first quarter, second quarter, third quarter. Like blueprint, they will give the good blueprint. Third is the realization. Realization phase. Realization is nothing but we have to start the project. In realization, our project people will be started. Our functional people will configure the entire module. Like depend upon SD module required, SD people configured, MM people, FI, HR, and all people, configuration started. Realization. It's one of the entry question. Which phase you are working the implementation project? Just we can say that realization, because our consultant people start working the realization. In coming to the layman language, it's our budget is completed and engineer is completed the mapping analysis. Then what happened? The manpower will start the working. Like start the pillars and slab and all this comes under the realization phase only. Fourth one is the final preparation. Final preparation means nothing but once all implementation completed, but we have to check everything it's suit to the customer required or not, and we have to go for the testing. Okay, it's working or not. Okay, if there is any errors, because we have to integrate the other mods. Our SD modules consultants completed the our task and MM people are completed their task. So we have to integrate SD, MM, FI, HR and all these things. While integration, it's working properly or not. We have to go for the integration testing also. All it's ready and we have some checklist. So we have to take the everything. Okay, SD model completed, FF model, FI model completed, MM model completed, HR model completed. So we have a checklist. We have to take all integration testing, unit testing completed, integration testing completed. Data migration means database also we have to moved from the previous system to our SAP system, because previously they are using .NET or Java something, because I already told you 1 lakh data customers and all this thing. So they have to map the data to the our SAP also. There is also database transfer also, migration also we required. All is completed, we have to check final in under final preparation. Like in our project, our house building, we have to check like fans and everything, pipes, and it's working properly, water is coming properly, water motors and all these things. So once it's completed, then fifth one is the go live. Go live means nothing but we have to implemented all this SAP into the customer system. It's a main important part of the project actually. While you are implementing the all the SAP into the our system only, your company system, we have to transfer the data and transfer the entire functions and the functional settings and the database and through interfaces to the customer place. While it's transferring, there is any issues, it's we have to take care. So we have to almost 3 to 4 days. It's almost pregnancy date, like delivery date. After go live, we have to give the support. Means grow probation. Coming to the our go live environment. While grow probation, we have to check all this current is available or power is available. Once it's completed, after 1 or 2 days, they have some issues like it's water is not coming. Maybe the fan is not working. Like we have some support required. We call the people and we take the support. Okay, it's not working. They will, minor changes they will do. Like once it's go live also, we have to give the support, because while taking the customer requirement and while implementing our project or SAP to the prime place, there are some mismatches or some difference, because we have to give the final prescription only end user training also how to use the product. So in case if they don't, for example, I am unable to create the order, I am unable to create the delivery, that time we have to give the some support also. This is also depend upon, while project preparation, we are have some agreement. Okay, once go live is completed, we will give the 15 months or 12 months or 6 months, we will give the support. This is also cost effect also, support also. It comes from the other technology.
Shiva, a doubt here. So on a real-time basis, what is that time frame for these activities?
Yeah.
Also, if you cover who does that exactly, so like maybe the very experienced guys, is there any a particular role that those consultant will actually work on these activities? That would be helpful.
Actually, this is depend upon the project. For example, small projects comes under within 1 year. In case of big projects, like present I'm working in the entertainment project, almost we are working for 10 years onwards this project.
Mm-hmm.
And only this realization base is completed within 1 year actually.
Okay.
Within 1 year, we implemented the project to the client. But what happened after that one, they go for the rollouts, like we done for the US. Then it's go for the UK, Canada, Ireland.
Mm-hmm.
And apart from this one also, they're going for the support also. And apart from this one, what happened, once implemented the project to the client place, if there is any new requirements, also they are giving. So depend upon project wise, but previous project, it was my previous project, only 2 years project one. We implemented within 1 year and we provided support for the 1 year. Then it's completed and they are using their own actually, because they created their own SAP consultancy and they're running.
Okay.
So mainly depend upon project only. Some people are agreement because their cost and all these things, they will check within 2 years or 3 years or 5 years. So while entering, in case of you joining any project, they will clearly tell you, clearly explain it. This is the 2 years project. This is the support 2 years. Or this is the implementation. We have to implement 1 year. And after that, we have to provide the 1 year support. Like, so they will give you proper dates and all this.
Okay. So as you have mentioned, we get into the scene from a realization activity, right?
Yeah.
So which level of consultants actually work on from project preparation and business blueprint?
Yeah, it's a good question. Coming to the project preparation business blueprint, they required some implementation experience candidates. For example, 3+ years experience candidates they required, and project manager level and steering committee actually they have. Apart from this one, they arranged some consultants like SD consultants, FI consultants, MM consultants who have a good knowledge in the implementation. They sent to the onset because we have to get the requirement and all this thing. So business blueprint and process preparation also depend upon the experience and means implementation experience. Not only 3S experience means in case of you have a support experience, I think they cannot take into the onset actually. Depend upon situation. In case there is no resource available, they have to send you. In case of resources is available for particular implementation experience, minimum 3 to 5 years experience is required. Then only they can work for the realization phase also.
Okay.
But also nowadays what happened in big companies and small companies, 5 years experience consultants they are maintaining, and apart from this they have taken the freshers also. But as a backup, like testing and all these things.
Okay.
So our main functional consultant, for example, 3 5 years experience, three people are they're putting as a freshers, like domain experience they are coming and directly they go to the SAP. Then they will provide you as a testing purpose, and they have some like documentation preparation support like.
Okay.
But in case of realization means you have experience in the minimum 3 to 5 years they require. And in case of business project preparation, they compulsory 100K and I think depend upon project, they need to go for the onset. And they have to take the talk to, they have to discuss with the client and they have to take the requirement. Here, project manager level also involved. Mainly, steering company involved.
And one more thing, they're going for business, separate module for separate persons, right? Not for one person collecting all the information.
Yeah, depend upon module. Maximum functional consultants only require for the client place actually. Because technical people, we have to give the our requirement to the technical means above people. Only functional means we have to understand the business requirement.
Realization stage, maybe technical people is involving in that.
Yes, they involved. But while business blueprint, we have to take the input from that technical people also. How much time it will take the development? For example, I have to take the some report. So technically, I have to ask for that. Okay, this kind of report, how many days it will take? They will say 2 months. Okay, depend upon their timelines, we can give the SL. This is the called SLA, service level agreement, because this is the one of the important for the support project.
Mm-hmm.
What is that SLA means? Nothing but how many days, like time frame for a project preparation, business rule, realization, final goal and support. These five things, what is the time frame? For example, 1 year, we have to give it. So definitely we have to give in the within 1 year only. In case of after 1 year, company need to pay the amount to the clients, because once we what we can say SLA increased it means, for example, 1 year is the time frame. Apart from 1 year, it will be extended. So in case there is any genuine reason, it's not a problem, depend upon client, it's okay. In case of there is any our side, it's a delay, so we company need to pay the amount. Like in support project, for example, within 3 to 5 hours, it's a high priority. We have to complete the within 3 to 5 hours support tickets. In case of more than that one, company need to pay that one. Because it's a production system, they are using lot of, they lost a lot of amount and all this in case of we are properly support for that particular issue. That time, we company need to pay the amount to the client. That comes on the SLA. So, timeliness is the main important in the any company, any project in SAP. Not only SAP, maybe .NET Java also, but coming to the SAP only, there is a high priority they will take. Timeliness is the main important.
So you are explaining the, all the steps you are explaining coming classes, right? For suppose,
yes,
what
exactly
are we doing in project preparation? What are we doing in business blueprint?
Yes.
And realization means you are explaining the this all the things. Yeah. Okay.
Yes, correct. These are the highlights only. While I'm going to the next all classes, just highlights, once we understand the what is the SAP, what is the ERP, what is the project we are going, then we can go into the our role actually. Coming to the, our SAP SD role. SAP SD, what kind of our functionality we have to go. All comes under the next classes.
Shiva, so we were talking about one of the project maintainers, let's say accelerated SAP methodology. So project management, one of the project management module. So is that a highly used, or is there any other methodologies that SAP, I mean, projects?
Highly used ASAP methodology, maximum 90% people using. And apart from this one, we have some other tools like I worked for the TM something. So one of the tools like we can put in all the project data into the tool, and we can go for the testing and all this thing. For it, I will tomorrow. One of the tools, but maximum 90% people use ASAP technology.
Thank you.
Reminding you tomorrow, just to quiz and all this, it's not required. Typical hardware to start with, what is the requirement? Like one data server and applications, servers, desktop with the presentation, this is the requirement section. LAN system means network is the main important part of the entirely SAP. And what does SAP stand for? What does ERP stand for? These are the quiz. I will share you this document to you. System application products and data processing, enterprise resource planning, ERP means SAP R2, financial accounting, and R3 structures model to R.
And here we require the. Sir, you may collect my our email IDs and all the things, sir. If you want to share some documents.
Just send to me in WhatsApp, okay?
Okay.
Your email ID. So forward you.
Okay. Hi Sandeep. Hello Sandeep.
Hello. Yeah, Shiva.
Yeah. Not Shiva. Trinath. I'm also a student.
Okay. Hi. Hi, buddy.
Yeah. Hi, Sandeep. Sandeep. After this week, next week onwards, we will go for the one-to-one classes, direct classroom training. You know the BHCL junction. It is there. Are you joining that session?
I just want to understand, like, would it be online and classroom as well, or only the classroom? Because sometimes it might be a bit challenging for me to attend the online, physical classes. So how it's going to be?
It depends upon the batch requirement and trainer availability. Trainer is already almost, this actually session is a classroom session only. But as a trainer is an out of station due to the reason, they will take the this week only, he will take online.
Okay.
If it is required, then we will think, even though if we will discuss about the other batchmates also, based on that, we can decide on that.
Yeah. That would be good.
Yeah. Okay, so Shiva garu. Then we'll end up the session today, and because it is almost 9:15.
Yeah, we can.
Yeah, sir. Tell me, sir.
Yeah, thank you, Trinath, and
We will share my email ID through this. Our group is there, no? Yes, the group through WhatsApp we will share.
Yeah.
Thank you, Andy. Thank you very much.